So, Flatnose, aren't you worried your kind will punish you for consorting with us?
My name is Maeselk Chucky.
Goblins?
And my kin will understand my need for servants. They will help you, but only if I ask.
Strange. It looks healthy, but it...
The pig's dead, my friend. Staring at it won't bring it back. Come on. We'll never fix these brain worms if we stop and gawk at every piece of carrion you find.
The boar seems to be fresh, only a few hours dead. But you can't find any sign of a wound.
See? Nothing. Come on, we're wasting our time.
Do you think your kin search for you, Lazelle?
I know they do not. It is my responsibility to...
They pursued the Nautiloid. Perhaps they were trying to free you.
A vain notion. I am one of many and will not be a burden to my queen.
Show up to save the druid. I'll cut you to pieces. Kill him!
Take you.
in candy!
His breaths are shallow, his wounds deep. He doesn't respond to your voice. His breaths are shallow, his wounds deep. He doesn't respond to your voice.
I was watching you at the Grove Gate. You spilled enough goblin blood to fill the Chiontha. Where'd you learn moves like that? Aye, yes. Loyalty. It seems a small price to pay for such might. Then the bill comes due. If someone must share in the blade's glory, better it be a champ like you. Was a time I didn't amount to much. But then, a higher purpose called to me. Killed a few goblins, freed a few captives, and I was hooked. The only life I want is a hero's. Now, let's get some rest. I do my best goblin killing at sunup.
You don't sleep well, flitting between dreams and nightmares. Maybe you wake up because you know something is wrong. Or maybe you just get lucky.
Shit. No, no, it's not what it looks like. I swear. I wasn't going to hurt you. I just needed, well, blood.
There, in dim firelight, you see him for what he really is. A vampire. A slave to sanguine hunger.
It's not what you think. I'm not some monster. I feed on animals. Boars, deer, kobolds, whatever I can get. I'm just too slow right now. Too weak. If I just had a little blood, I could think clearer, fight better. Please. At best, I was sure you'd say no. More likely, you'd ram a stake through my ribs. No. I needed you to trust me. And you can trust me. Thank you. Do you think you could trust me just a little further? I only need a taste. I swear. Really? Of course. Not one drop more.
He holds you carefully, delicately, until he strikes. It's like a shard of ice into your neck, a quick, sharp pain that fades to throbbing numbness. Your breath catches, your pulse quickens.
Hmm? Oh, of course. Amazing. My mind is finally clear. I feel strong. I feel happy. Shouldn't take long. So many people need killing. Now, if you'll excuse me, you're invigorating, but I need something more filling.
You watch as he stalks towards the forest. Stronger, more confident, ready to hunt.
This is a gift, you know. I won't forget it. Good morning. How do you feel? It'll pass. Just be glad I'm not a true vampire. A bite from them and you might wake up as a vampire spawn, like my good self. All of a vampire's hunger, but few of their powers. Oh no, I should be cinders in this light. I hadn't seen the sun for 200 years before we crashed here. Someone, or something, wants me alive. They've changed the rules. Some of the rules, at least. Running water still burns like acid, and I don't know if I need an invitation to enter a house. As for my other quirks, well, we can figure those out in time. That's my theory, but who knows? I'm just glad you're being sensible about these revelations. I was worried people might turn up with torches and pitchforks. Although there's still time.
A vampire? Well, that explains the pallor. Given our group's nature, I don't see much harm. We're each monsters in the making, after all.
Quite the opposite. I'm here in the spirit of openness and honesty to work together as a team.
His breaths are shallow, his wounds deep. He doesn't respond to your voice.